I'm Dr. Wendy, and this here is my parakeet friend, Tootsie. Basically, we're here today to talk about ways that you can enrich your bird's life in the wild. Birds have many activities that they're doing. They're flying, they're foraging for their food, they're socializing with other birds, but in a caged environment, sometimes that can be difficult, so it's important as a pet bird owner to stimulate your bird's life in captivity. So there are many different ways that we can do this, and that's what we're going to be talking about today. So the first thing is providing companionship. Tootsie here is an only bird, so if you're going to be leaving the home, which most people do, you know, on a daily basis, it's a good idea to have ways of keeping the bird company. One such way could be a mirror. You can see there's a mirror in this cage. The mirror can actually help the bird see his or her reflection. Kind of makes them feel like there's another bird there. Other things you can do are turning on noise. So that could be like leaving a TV on or radio on. They even make tapes and CDs with bird noises and bird sounds that might help soothe the bird. And also keeping the cage by a nice undrafted window would be good too, because they can look at the birds outside, and that also helps keep them company. And when you are home, a good place to have the bird would be in an area where the family spends a lot of time. You don't want to keep the bird isolated away from everybody. So those are some pointers on how to keep your bird company. Foraging is also another big thing that birds do in the wild. So there's lots of products available to help simulate this in a caged environment. I just have one here. This is just called the Barrel of Fun. Basically, you just put the food in there and they have to work to get it out. So that's very important. The other thing that's very important is birds love to preen in the wild. Preening is a very important behavior of birds. And if you don't simulate that in a caged environment, what will end up happening is the bird could start feather picking or doing other types of things like that. And we do have some preening type toys like this pine cone here. They eat the seed, but afterwards they can pick at it. There's some other ones available as well. The other type of thing that you would want to provide for your pet bird is a place for them to have some privacy or to hide out. They would normally do this in trees and brush in the wild, but we have here an example. This is just a happy hut you can hang in the cage, and that will give them a place to kind of hide and have their privacy when they need it. And if you have a female, it can also help with nesting as well, should that be something that they would need. The other things that you'll want to do is just provide stimulation for your bird, so any kind of interactive toys would be important to show or be important to have. This one here is just one. There's just some color blocks with a bell at the bottom. And you can even take your bird out of the cage and use something like this, bird playground, which is perfect. They can play around. If you are going to use something like this, make sure you're keeping the bird in a confined area so they don't fly away or escape outside of your home, or make sure their wings are clipped if you're going to do that. The other thing that you'll want to do is make sure there's a perch. Here's an example of one of the perches we have here, but as you can see, Tootsie already has perches in the cage. The perches are important to help file down the nails. Again, in the wild, they would simulate this by sitting on a bush or if sitting on a tree or things like that, but you can do that. Make sure there's a perch, and see how Tootsie has two layers or two levels. They like the levels, so make sure you have like a lower one and a higher one. And a nice size cage is really important as well. You don't want to keep them in anything too small. So there's so many things to choose from here that can keep your bird busy and interested and help decrease the risk that they're going to have any kind of other behavioral problems. Providing enrichment is very important. You do need to be patient in the beginning, because a lot of birds will be scared when you just introduce a new toy. So you want to introduce that gradually and use a lot of patience with that. Once you do have toys that the bird does get used to, another pointer is to rotate the toys at least a couple of times a month. The reason being, you don't want them to get bored with anything either. So constant rotation of the toys. Like I said, there's so many to choose from. There should be no reason why you can't do that. All of these things should be helpful to you to help keep your bird as healthy and happy as possible. I hope you found this helpful, and thank you very much.